Hello everyone, this is Atsushi here, and today we are going to be predicting the next chapter in Ruby Volume 5. The finale is going to be the next prediction, the final prediction for the volume. This volume did go by pretty quickly. It really went by fast, and now we're getting Ruby Chibi Season 3 next Saturday. It's going to be starting immediately. So it's like, what the heck? I wanted to take a break, but I did make my thoughts on that of the announcement, and some changes are gonna be happening. So once my Ruby everything wrong with Ruby Volume 5 comes out, that is when the new schedule is gonna be starting, because I want to get that done first, and then I'll start with new shows to watch. Like, I'm gonna be watching two shows now, because I'm still focusing on movies, right? I got rid of a couple of them, like Camp Camp, Red Mist of Blue, Season 16. Camp Camp Season 3, I'm not gonna react to anymore. But the major ones, here's what I'm gonna be reacting to using this schedule after everything went with Ruby Volume 5. Mondays is gonna be One Punch Man. Fridays is going to be Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. And Saturdays are gonna be Nostalgia Critic if he releases an episode for him and Ruby Chibi. That's gonna be the schedule now. Is I'm not gonna be doing reviews anymore because that's gonna be during Volume 6. I'm kind of predicting of not doing reactions for Volume 6. I'm kind of going through that route of like, maybe I shouldn't be doing these because I'm not that good at it, but this is my thing I like to do for fun. So I don't know what's in store. I am still going to be doing Ruby AV, so still get excited for those. I might watch Genlock. I might react to Genlock. I might. At this point, I'm still debating on that. I will be reacting to Attack on Titan Season 3, which will be coming in July of 2018. We do know that officially. I am really looking forward to that season because I did finish Season 1 and 2. I did at one point react to it, but I stopped because of the whole blocking issue, and I know like kind of what to do to not trigger the blocked everything worldwide stuff and kind of know what I'm doing a little bit more. So that's gonna be a major improvement for me right now. All right, let's talk about beauty science from all of that. Let's predict the next episode. So I really want Adam to do something in this episode, like probably take somebody out with him, because I really don't see him going out like the way he did in chapter 13. It really seems like that they still have something in store for him in this next episode in the finale, and I really hope they do like a fight between Blake and Adam. But before that, he kills off a major character from Blake, like maybe her father or something. But I'm predicting Sun could possibly die if they do this route, if they do have Adam kill someone off that she loves or at least admires for as a character and for herself as a person. I think it would be better for them to kill Sun. I'm not saying Sun's an awful character, I'm just saying with the character go for the character development. It would be better to do that route. Or they could kill Ilya, which is possible as well. They could kill Gila, they could kill Kali, but I think the one that's most in clear vicinity with Adam is Sun. So that one, it makes most sense if you're going to kill someone off like that. Because I really, and then after that, we might get like Blake versus Adam thing going on. And then after that, I hope we get some more like fights in between, maybe with one with Hazel and Weiss or someone else of that nature fighting, or we like just not get anything from that. But these are the next parts that are gonna be a little bit tricky. Now, there is gonna be, I think, a conversation between Raven and Yae. We know that's gonna be happening from the cliffhanger. Some people are suggesting, are they gonna fight? Are they gonna not? I think they're not. I think it's gonna be a civil discussion. I think Raven is gonna try and convince Yane that Aspen is not the man that she think he is, and she'll probably use Rhetoric and knowledge, like if you do this, you'll learn something that he never told you about, or something like that, like maybe how Summer Rose died. Because we need a very good twist in this next finale, and I think here's what I think they're gonna be doing. All right, I really hope that I'm right on this, is that Aspen was the main reason, or is the reason where someone else died. I imagine the reaction from Yane and to the audience for this thing, like he kept this a secret from everybody. And that would be the breaking point of Yane's, like, no, I'm done with this. And I might take Ruby with me, might go do our own thing. That would be an amazing twist. That would be better than Raven being the Spring Maiden, because they need something like that for this finale. I'm really hoping for a 25-minute episode of the finale as well. I'm not suspecting it, and I hope we also get some medical knowledge information. Maybe we could get flashbacks. That would be nice too to see. I would love to see some flashbacks of how Summer died, because during Volume 4, Chloe was like, she's not coming, Ty. I believe that was during Summer Rose's death, or at least something happened to her at that point. I really wonder what that could be. And I think if it is a good time to reveal it, it would be now. I really do think so. Because someone like Raven should know stuff about this, or the medical knowledge, they can do that as a plot device for Yane to not blame an Ospen. Because honestly, I don't trust Ospen at all. And this might be the breaking point for everyone. It's like, okay, dude, you just tell us the truth on everything at this point, like what's been going on and everything. And as for the post-credit scene, what are we gonna see? I'm guessing we're gonna see Cinder being alive, or is something else going to happen with the post-credit scene? Possibly Cinder is coming back, like, yeah, I'm back now. I'm not dead, because I don't think they're done with her yet. Because that would be kind of weird if Raven gets a kill on Cinder instead of Ruby or Jean. It would be weird after everything that they've set it up for them, for those two. Yeah, either they might do like a thing where Cinder just kills Raven off the spot, and then Raven's last thought was Yane. She becomes a Spring Maiden, and that could be the case as well. But I think they need like a big twist to happen in this chapter. And I do think it could be either Yane being the Spring Maiden at some point, Raven gets killed off from Cinder by a big surprise, like a haha, gotcha, and then kills her right off. Or they could reveal that Summer Rose, the reason why Summer Rose died was because of Ospen. I do believe they might go that route, and the post-credit scene being Cinder coming back, or that nature coming. Now, I will be doing a prediction video for Volume 6, but that'll be in a couple of weeks, probably next couple of months, because I want to wait a little bit before I do that video. So, I'm really hoping for the episode length of the episode to at least be 25 minutes, 25 or 30 minutes of an episode for the finale, because usually the finales are the longest of the volume, and what we had so far was like 20 minutes, 20 to 21 minutes long episode. So I think 30 minutes might be the case with this episode to be happening. I really hope for a long episode of Ruby Volume 5's finale, and I also hope there might be some thing with Salem. She might do something after this point, because after the failure of Haven, if it fails, or it might be another Deus Ex Machina killing off Haven Academy, or at least the CCT Tower with it. And I think what also would be interesting is if, of the matter of fact, when Raven goes to use the Relic of Knowledge, she can't use it. She is not worthy to use it. But you know who is? Yane. She would be the worthy one to use the Relic of Knowledge, and she gets some memories, or she sees how some of those died, or something like that, someone that is very close to her, and it was a result of Ospen. I really do think they might be going that route, because that would be very interesting, and I want to learn more, like, if inside the vault is, like, a different dimension of some sort, is Salem in a different dimension like this? What is this place that is inside a vault? Because that looks very interesting, to say the least, of what that is going to be entailing. So yeah, this was my final prediction of Ruby Volume 5. It's been a wild ride with this volume. Even though this volume was meh, to be honest, it was meh. There was some good moments, but there was some awful moments as well. I'm gonna go in with Volume 6 with low expectations, to be honest. That's where I'm gonna be going with Volume 6. Like, okay, I'm expecting Volume 6 to not be that great. Prove me wrong. I'm that's where I'm going with Volume 6. So, what do you guys think is going to be happening for now? Leave your thoughts down below in the comment section, or to leave a like, comment, and subscribe for official videos like these. And I'll see you all next time. Bye.